With that, we want to check in now with one of our experts. As businesses are making adjustments and adding cleaning procedures to their to-do list, there are concerns about the safety of those cleaning products, of course. So joining us live, Dr. Anna Maria Temple. Good to see you on this Tuesday, Dr. Temple.
Great to see you.
So first, how safe is it to inhale or have these chemicals at restaurants? Does it pose a risk to us or our food?
I am very concerned about the bleach that, you know, everybody is going out and buying bleach. I haven't had bleach on my counters in many years because of my concerns over toxicity from breathing it in, from exposure to our skin. And I worry, you know, especially with restaurants and all the schools and daycares opening, and these are sprayed everywhere and the kids are crawling on stuff. And especially in restaurants where food is touching the surfaces, I really don't want my food touching a surface that has bleach on it and then I'm going to be eating it.
So for us at home, what are some alternatives that we could be using?
You know, hydrogen peroxide is a great alternative, and it's cheap and it's easy. No one is going out and getting it. There's plenty available. You go to the grocery store, it's about $3. The thing with hydrogen peroxide, you have to leave it on the surface until it dries, because that's how it kills the virus. And also soap and water. Soap and water is like the old school way, because the soap, the friction breaks the virus particle apart. The soap part breaks the virus apart, and it is actually one of the most effective ways of getting rid of the virus with low toxicity.
So a lot of parents are worried now about these new symptoms we're seeing, like inflammation in kids, possibly linked to COVID-19. Can you explain what parents should be looking out for, and should we be concerned with this?
The thing that is coming out is that we're seeing an increased number in kids having what is called a multi-system inflammatory disease, which is also known as Kawasaki's disease. This is a symptoms of illness where the children are becoming significantly inflamed and has been around for a long time. Usually we see a peak in spring, and it's related to many viruses, from rhinovirus, which is the common cold, flu, metapneumovirus, and you name it. However, it's not a lot of cases. We're seeing a few more cases since the COVID-19 has been around. However, what parents need to keep in mind, that they're hearing a lot about it in the news, but it's still a very, very rare complication of COVID-19. Children are still overall doing really well. Of course, they're getting it. Some of them are getting sick. Some are getting a little sicker than others, but overall, children overall are doing well, being able to overcome this illness.
Dr. Temple, thank you so much for being with us today. We always appreciate your time and expertise.
Thank you so much.
Thanks.